How about we take this NV90 bin, it's never been used for anything yet, and weigh it. Let's see what the empty clean weight is. So I'm seeing 1201.5 grams empty and clean. Greetings, Shark Rotator XL fans. Isn't this refurbed trash find a beauty now? And keep in mind, since we've rejiggered the brush roll, new end caps, new bearings, and of course just a general cleanup, this machine should be running in tip-top shape. So let's go ahead and start the whole house cleaning.
Rotator part is nice. Gets into those tight little spots. So if you haven't noticed, I just took the turbo tool off because frankly it was making the machine tilt to the right too much. So you can get under some furniture a few inches, but you can't go underneath most of what I have. It is very easy to push forward and backward, but I would say that the handle weight is definitely on the heavy side. You feel like you're holding up the whole machine, because you kind of are. But it's very easy to turn, and it's very easy to push forward and backward on my medium pile carpet. And not all of my machines do that. It's not too loud, nor is it soft, just kind of in the middle. Over grates just fine. That's nice.
how well it travels on the rear wheels. Oh, nice job. Very nice to push, very nice to maneuver. Heavy handle, but the maneuverability almost makes up for it. So the smaller head gets into tighter corners, to be sure, but a smaller head means it's going to take you longer to finish the job. So it's a trade-off. It's not exactly always a win-win to have a smaller power knob. And away we go on the rear wheels, as long as I don't step on the cord.
HEPA exhaust actually blows in my face once in a while. It's kind of funny. You wouldn't think that it would blow up at all, but it does. You get it just the right angle, you get a little poof. Luckily enough, it smells nice, and the filtration, as we test it with the particle meter, is just about perfect. So let's see, I haven't stepped on all of this, but there you go. There's some of the carpet lines right there. Some people might like that style, some people might not. Let's see where we are so far. So there's stuff somewhere. And oh, that's like, there's nothing there. That's because it's stuck right there. It's kind of funny. Like, where the heck did it? I mean, it's up there. What's it doing up there? There's some down there, but it's a lot of it up there. Okay, so let's take this red and white gorgeous shark and go downstairs, finish up what we're doing. Back there. Okay. Let's go over to the last
two rooms.
Thank you.
does it for this session here with the Rotator XL. So let's go down to the lab and see how much dirt it picked up. Let's look at the hair wrap. And for 1,000 square feet, that's not bad. I mean, it bunches up here. It's there. I'm going to have to pick it out. It's definitely concentrated over on this side. Obviously, this is where the air intake is. Then this side. So it seems like whatever hair you get starts over here and then definitely starts to clump over here. And if left alone, well, it's going to make the brush roll look like the condition I found it in when I got it at the curb. Really, really terrible. So I've seen worse. So I would just call this average for hair wrap. So let's see what the raw bin pickup is. Started out with 1201.5 grams. And we ended up with, make sure that's centered, not wobbly. That's nice, and it's nice that you can't see it. So over there a little bit. So 1209.6, and then let's subtract 1201.5. We end up with 8.1 raw bin pickup, and it's going to be mostly fibrous material. So let's extract this and see what we get. Now the fun part, I've got to get all of that out, or as much as possible. Let's see if it sits better that way. There we go. That's just so funny that that's where it sits. Well, I guess I have to shake it down there. Oh, good. It all came down, or at least most of it. Okay, that's probably all that most people would normally be able to get out of there. Boy, that's a lot of fibrous material. I mean, that is a lot of fibrous material. So let's see. Switch over to grams. Had it on ounces. And I will do the best to separate all that I can. So there's a blob of fibrous material. And, oh, geez. Okay. Well, you know what? I picked it up, so I'm going to count it. It's not actually tape. It's something else. It's non-sticky. But you know what? That's fibrous material. Whatever that is. No, that isn't normal pickup for me. So it's just kind of funny. Like, where did that come from? Okay, here's more fibrous material. And the rest is going to be medium and fine dust, or you could say, well, you know what, really, that's just a lot of medium and heavy dirt. I really don't see a whole lot of fine dust. So 5.39, mostly fibrous. And let's see if I can get this in here without spilling it. And get a total. Okay, some of it's sticking to the paper a bit here. Come on. All right, that did it. Okay, so we ended up with extracted 6.75. So that means there's definitely well over a gram of something still stuck in there somewhere. And if I'm remembering right, that is really close to what the NV22 got. That's pretty amazing. So the extracted amount corrected for 1,000 square feet, I mean, we only did 1,000 square feet, so there's no need to actually correct the numbers, is coming in at less than 7. So that means that on my medium pile carpet, this machine right here is a little less than average, which is about the same as the NV22 when I tested it some time ago. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for more.